I really like that part of economic development. You just sit down with folks in your community and your state and you try to work through problems together. Sometimes it's infrastructure problems, sometimes it's flooding problems like we talked a little bit about this morning, but whatever it is, it's trying to help the core of your economy grow. And if you look at a state, if you look at a community, about 75 to 80% of the jobs are created by the companies that have already invested in your community, have already hired your citizens and continue to do that. And so to me, that's the top strategy that we can put together about attracting businesses, developing talent, not just attracting talent and retaining talent, but helping improve the skill set of the workforce that you have today. And so those are some of the things that we're working on at the Department of Economic Development. If you're not familiar with our agency, we are a fairly large organization of about 650, a little bit more than that, employees. We have the Division of Tourism, we have the Division of Workforce Development, the Division of Energy that works with companies trying to increase their efficiency on the energy usage and lighting, and then our core business and community services, which is our main interface with the business community on things like incentive programs and community development issues, community development block grants, and things like that. So it's a really, it's a neat organization. We get to do a lot of different things, but all of this is focused towards helping our state's economy grow. As frankly, your strategy is spot on. All the small business incubator and the GoCat program, I mean, that's exactly the kind of innovations I think that will help you take advantage of growth opportunities going forward. So we're working on a strategic plan. My main concern, frankly, is we have not been as strategic as we need to be as a department in terms of how we approach economic development. We've got a lot of good folks doing a lot of good things, but I think we just need to sharpen our approach and be a little bit more purposeful, frankly, about how we do some things. And so it shouldn't be a surprise to you if you heard a couple of the themes already in what I'm talking about, but the first and most important thing I think we as a state need to do better is tell our story. I think there's, whether it's recruiting businesses or recruiting people, recruiting students, I don't know that we're telling Missouri's story in a way that really helps break through some of the noise that's out there. There's maybe some good narratives, there's some bad narratives. We want to make sure that information is getting out there in a way that really helps encourage growth and frankly helps complement what you're doing in your community to tell your own story. I think as a state we can support you in that regard. So that's item number one on the to-do list, tell our story better is in terms of attracting talent, attracting businesses and students and any other folks that are looking at your community or looking at your state. Number two is growing businesses and really having a strategic plan for economic development. It has to do with supporting and assisting your existing businesses, entrepreneurship and innovation. The governor charged us, and Heather was a part of that task force earlier this year, but the governor charged Missouri with becoming the hub of innovation and entrepreneurship anywhere between the coasts. He didn't say go out and be a little bit better in entrepreneurship. He said go be the number one anywhere between the East and West Coast. And so how we can plug in West Plains with the entrepreneurship opportunities and innovation that's going on all across the state, the resources that are happening here, I think there's a network that we can really build on to make sure that everybody is sharing these ideas. And you've got a really good leader in Heather in particular. The third piece of that category is really recruiting businesses. The industries that we're trying to grow, the marketing that we're trying to do that, we want to make sure that we're really spot on in terms of how we approach it. Because as much as we love our community and as much as we love our state, every other state in the country and every other country, frankly, in the developed world at least, is out there trying to recruit for the same folks as we are and the same opportunities as we are. So we need to be, frankly, a little bit more strategic in how we approach that. So then the next piece of it is really, like I talked about earlier, was the workforce development and talent piece. I think if we can help K-12, higher ed, and the workforce system align specifically with what the business community needs, that's going to make our opportunities as a state so much better, not just to help our businesses grow, but frankly to provide some opportunities for our citizens and folks who want to get jobs and want to increase their earnings potential by increasing their skill sets. There's a lot of work to do in that space in particular, but we're working very closely with our partners at the Department of Higher Ed. I think we have to start with better data in terms of what does the economy need, jobs 5, 10, 15 years down the line. It's kind of hard to think about this, but what's happening in classrooms today, we're training people for jobs that might not have even been invented yet. And so you have to start with a really solid understanding of what's out there in the economy and equip our citizens with the tools to innovate and to drive knowledge, because that's what's driving innovation at companies like had the opportunity to visit this morning. And so talent development is really key in terms of how we as a state remain more competitive. The last piece of it, and I'm sorry it's not a 13-point plan. I know you just ate and you probably don't want to hear any more points of this plan, but the really last important component of it, I think, is community development. And sometimes that is overlooked in the economic development discussion because, you know, you're talking about business growth and cutting ribbons and everybody gets excited about that, but you have to have the infrastructure underpinning all of that, whether it's roads and bridges, obviously, but, you know, in the 21st century, broadband, IT, high-tech or high-speed internet, I think, is a key component to our growth as a state. And we need to work on that together. And so those are the big issues as I see it in terms of economic development. Really, I appreciate the opportunity to visit and to get outside of Jefferson City, because honestly, I really, as I approach my work, it's not about our state organization, it's about how we can better support your community. As I mentioned earlier, this thing, communities is really where economic development happens. And as a state, I want to make sure that our agency is here to support you and to support David and your entire team, and we'll do whatever we can.